because I've been avoiding this all day long.
How are you all today? Thank you.
Discovered this some time ago. The nice weather, this could be pleasant.
Oh, I think this is just delightful. Last time we ate was out behind Mike's office, but this is far more pleasant. It'd be nice looking. How come you don't get to see the view?
Well, and he says that maybe the story of the 82 hours is going to be in question about the polling systems. That they, yeah. When he said there, it seems he think how are things everybody got?
She was reading, standing in front of them, reading something to them from this piece of paper, and then when she put it down, she shook hands with him and shook hands with the little boy, and then they all broke up and went away.
And the ceremony, sir?
Huh?
It was probably a Muslim ceremony sometimes.
Oh, do you think that was it?
Sounds
like it. Because she had just looked like a piece of paper about like that. She was reading first. I thought maybe she was marrying him. But then I saw the kid, and I said, "No, that can't be." He was in the uniform. She was.
I would imagine. I don't know. Didn't know
the answer.
It was probably somebody from Milwaukee who was reenlisting in the service. We got one of the officers from over there to do it on the South Lawn.
All right.
We thank you, Mr. President.
Well, it's a pleasure.
It does look like a little bit. We've been here before.
We're going to see a lot of things.
Very happy today to be welcoming President Monte Enrique here as our guest.
Mr. President, are you talking about El Salvador, Mr. President? Are you talking about El Salvador?
So we'll be talking about a lot of things having to do with Central America and the Caribbean initiative.
Well, are you prepared to cut aid to El Salvador if they don't clean up the judicial system?
No questions. Got a photo opportunity.
The last election. we might be able to do with regard to the political side of our administration here. Some thoughts and ideas you may have of things we maybe are doing
where you came. And we agreed what we would do is each of us would give our suggestions about looking to 1984, things that we could do or things that we could do better. They will channel them into the Republican National Committee. We'll summarize them and edit them a little bit and get them down and get them down to you. So maybe we can do that and give everyone a little opportunity to give some thought to it and work out some of the details. So we'll be glad to do that. But one thing that I think we all believe, we all feel good about the
Well, just go on every day in here.
Very business-like atmosphere, but and I must confess, I like it this way. Strong, don't you?
No, I was probably something so that you won't forget.
Mr. President, I just...
All I tell you is it's great attention
when I left. It's very meaningful to Ann and me. And I'm glad I'm getting Ann out of town. She is beginning to like this city. Getting her out while I'm still ahead. But, Mr. President, you've been an inspiration to so many people since those...
I thought you'd never offer.
You've been an inspiration to so many people, and to me particularly, ever since that 1968 convention. And one of my favorite people, but he's house to the president.
Thank you very much. Jim, it isn't my party.
Oh, sir.
And his blockage was 95, 90, and 80.
So he's lucky to have had it.
He's going to feel very good from now on. I just got the word.
Is he at the Medical University of South Carolina, by
the way? St. Joseph's Hospital. Well, listen, I thank you very much for those kind words, but I thank you for more than that. I thank you for doing what you came here to do, and I think I speak for everybody when I say that not only we're going to miss you very much, but we wish you the very best in what you're going on to do now.
Thank you, Mr. President.
And so I will ask you all again our glasses for the real guests of our creator.
Here.
Dr. Edwards.
Yes.
President.
Yes.
President. And all the moaning that I heard from the 9 chancellors, presidents, you might say, of the University of California when I was governor. You're going to have all the problems. Well,
thank you, Mr. President. Could I,
President Edwards,
could I say a few words about our friend over here? You know, Strom was a hard man to get on board in 68. You remember that?
I'd already committed to that.
I knew we were in trouble because he had already committed. He's a man of his word, and I tell you, he's been a great American, a great patriot, too, and I just would like to ask all of you here to raise your glasses to my longtime good friend, and truly one of the great patriots of all times, a great statesman, my friend Strom Thurmond.
Well, thank you. I recommend you. Yes, I know that Strom's a man of his word. The only time I didn't appreciate that was in 68.
You know I would have had you at, but you waited too late.
It was that Atlanta meeting that
I want to say this. I've been here for 28 years. You are the greatest president in 28 years I've been here, and I think you'll go down as one of the greatest presidents in history of all time.
Yeah. Yeah.
strong if the distaff side might say something. I think that the president has a very great first lady. And I would like, I just enjoy knowing her, and I would like us to drink to the first lady.
Yes, and that's the way. And you've done a fine job yourself. Now let's drink to that.